What's good, everybody? This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters, the biggest Miami Hurricane fan of all time. Guys, today we're going to be talking about the distributive property, and we're going to be talking about what it means to distribute and how to actually distribute. So I'm going to ask you guys, if you can, to like, subscribe to our channel, leave a comment, let us know any other videos or topics that you guys would like for us to cover. All right, let's get started. So the distributive property, we've probably seen some type of expression that looks like this. It says A, and then in parentheses, we have B plus C. All right, and that is equal to AB plus AC. So this, like I said, is the distributive property. And what you need to understand, guys, is that we're gonna have an outside term, right? Which is represented by A right now. So the outside term will either be a number or a variable, and we're gonna take that number or variable and multiply it by the terms inside the parentheses, which are B and C. So once we do that, we're gonna have A times B plus A times C, and if they're alike terms, we can add them, okay? But today, we're only going to talk about the distributive property. We're not going to talk about adding like terms for today. So let's start off with our first example. So we have 7, and then in parentheses, x plus 4. So what they're asking us to do when they say to distribute in this problem is, they want us to do 7 times x, and then 7 times 4. So I'm going to write this out, right? So when we have 7 times x, plus 7 times 4, that's going to give us a final answer of 7x plus 28, right? And we know that these aren't like terms, okay? Now let's say, let's switch the problem up, and let's say instead of it being a x plus 4, let's throw a subtraction sign in there, and let's see how that changes the problem. So our second example, we have 4, right? We have a minus 4. And then in parentheses, we have y minus 3. So what I want you guys to understand is it's the same rules apply. We're going to take that outside term, and we're going to multiply it by the expression inside the parentheses. So that means every term inside the parentheses will be multiplied by that outside number or variable. So in this problem, that's going to be negative 4 times y, and then negative 4 times negative 3. What happens a lot of times is people think that you're going to do negative 4 minus 3. No, remember that this is a distributive property, so we're multiplying. So once we write this on out, we should have negative 4 times y, which will give us negative 4y. And then we're going to add, right, negative 4 times negative 3. And we should just know that that's going to give us a positive number, and that's plus 12. All right? So when you have the negatives in there, don't think that you're actually going to be subtracting, guys. You're just multiplying, and the sign is going to be negative this time. All right? Let's go on to another one. So let's say in this next example, we're distributing, but instead of us having two terms, we have like three terms. So let's say we had 2x plus 3y plus 2z, right? So what I want you guys to understand is everyone may think, hey, Mr. Peters, I haven't seen the other problems we had before only had two terms. This one has three. So guys, after highlighting all of these terms, I want you to know something. The same rules are gonna apply. The only difference now is we're going to multiply three times instead of two. So let's scroll the screen up to the top some, and let's actually distribute with this problem. So in this problem, we're going to have 5 times 2x plus 5 times 3y plus 5 times 2z. Right? And then once we go through, we're only going to multiply the numbers and then keep the variable. Right? So we'll have 10x plus 15y plus 10z. And like we said before, none of these variables are the same, so we can't add any of these variables. All we could do is leave it as a expression like we have here. So guys, just remember, when we're talking about a distributive property, that means we're going to multiply. All right, you're going to have an outside term. You're going to multiply by all the terms in the expression that are inside the parentheses. After you do that, guys, just make sure you pay attention to your signs. Whether the numbers are positive or negative doesn't mean you're going to add them. No, you have to first distribute and multiply. So thank you guys for joining us again today. This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters, the biggest Miami Hurricane fan of all time. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and leave a comment on this video. Thank you.